Go ahead and check out the description box for all the tidbits and the information I give you on how to contact me, etc., etc. So now with the nitty gritty, the hair. Today's hairstyle I like to call the princess twist. I don't have any other name for it, that's just what I call it. So if you do, let me know. But it's a very versatile look, one of my favorite looks to wear. You can dress it up, dress it down, wear it for a night out, you can wear it to work. It's just that versatile. So stick around and you're going to see just how easy, flexible, and beautiful this look is. All right, let's get started. Here's what you need. Hair moisturizer. I'm using Hair Food by Softy. Styling gel. This is Ampro's Shine and Jam. Of course, a good hairbrush. And ladies with thick hair like me, you know we have to have that wide tooth comb. Bobby pins. Rubber bands or scrunchies. So step one is to take your hair and to part it into a square. As you can see, I'm just parting my hair neatly to make sure that it is all into a nice square. Once you've sectioned that hair off into a square, you can go ahead and move it out the way because you won't need to do anything with it just yet. Step two is to take your hair and part it from ear to ear. As you can see, I'm parting one side, I'm going straight to the next side, all the way across. From the back of my ear, on one side and the other. I'm gonna go ahead and put this hair out the way so that I can move on to my next step. Step three, I'll brush the loose hair into a mini ponytail and band it. As you can see, taking my rubber band and putting the hair right through. Okay, so this is just a step in between the step because oil moisturizing, it's very important. I'm going to use just a little moisturizer and glaze it over my hair and on the hair that's in the rubber band. I'm going to do that for every section. But now I'm moving right along and I'm going to part and band this next section just the same way I did the first one. And so that none of this hair gets tangled up with the hair I'm putting in the rubber band, I'm gonna move that out the way. And I'll brush this on up into my ponytail. Okay, continuing on, just like the first two sections, I'm doing these last two the same exact way. I'll have four total, and I'm putting this section into a rubber band. So I'm sure you got this down pat, right? Once your four ponytails are banded, you'll start with the first one and go ahead and twist it all the way down to the ends.
After twisting it to the end, I'm going to pin it by rolling it. So I'll take a bobby pin. I'm going to put it towards the back of me, rolling backwards and pinning. So I'll brush this second ponytail and twist it just like I did the first one, all the way down to the end. Except once I've twisted this one to the end, I'm going to roll it forward. As you can see, and stick a pin in it. Alright, and guess what we're gonna do with this one? That's why we're gonna twist it. And I'm gonna roll this one towards the front as well. And where you place the pin doesn't really matter, just as long as you have it joined with the one before it. As you can see, the last section, I'm doing the same thing. Once they're all pinned down, you can go ahead and spread them out just to get them as full as you can make them without unraveling the twist. Just to secure them, I'm gonna pin them down a little on the side. And remember, you're doing each one the same way. So once you've worked your way all the way up to the front, you take that hair that's loose and go ahead and brush it just a little bit to tease it. Take your comb, divide that section into two. And with the first one, go ahead, twist it down all the way to the end. Now it doesn't have to be tight. I'm going to leave that loose and do the same thing with the next. I'll intertwine these two sections, not fully twisting them, but just twisting them around each other and roll them up. I will stick a pin on the side to secure it and one in the front. You can just pin it down until you feel that it is tight enough and secure for you. And finally, you've made it to the last step. You take some of your styling gel and slick down those edges all the way to the back. And this is going to define and tighten up that look. Make sure you pay close attention to the kitchen, because yes, the kitchen can get messy, ladies. And now we're just going to slick down those front pieces just a little more onto the sideburns. On both sides. And that is a wrap. Here's the completed look. There you have it. Not too bad, right? Well, I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. I thank you again for watching it. It's okay if you don't get the style right or perfect the very first time you try it. That's why you can go back and watch this video as many times as you need to. Practice as much as you have to. Play with the twists. Play with the placements of the bobby pins. And you can alter this look as much as you need to until you get it the way that suits you. So that is my time, but I must remind you once again to please subscribe. Check that description box for contact information. If you do try this style, please send me your pics and videos, because I would love to hear from you as always. And that's my time. Till next time.